This is the Evolution Evo Mag 42. This is a magnetic base drill that can cut up to 42mm holes in metal quite easily using the supplied cutters. You can also fit a normal chuck to this, which does enable you to use a traditional drill bit. Compared to other mag base drills, this machine is extremely light. Not only that, but the actual magnet on this machine is very powerful. These are the types of cutters you can use with this machine, up to 42mm in diameter. These actually have a hole going all the way through the centre for the coolant to go through. So it is incredibly easy to keep the bit cool when you are using it. This is the case that the mag drill comes in. I'll just explain what you get. You actually get this bracket for holding the coolant bottle. You then get a guide to go around the bottom of the drill should you wish to use it. You then get the coolant bottle. You also get the hose to connect the coolant bottle to the machine. And then we have the three screw-in handles, which simply screw into the machine on the front there. And then we have a strap for when you are using the machine on a vertical surface. That is very important. If you're ever using one of these and it is in a position where it could fall if the electricity was cut to it, it is absolutely critical that you use that to hold it in position. And then we have the chuck adapter, that simply screws in there. That enables you to use a normal drill bit with this machine. You then get a selection of X keys and also a chuck key for the chuck. We're just going to start off by screwing in all of the handles. If you've never used a mag drill before, these are very, very handy machines. They can save you a lot of time and a lot of hassle when you're drilling metal on site. Basically, at the side there, you have the handles, which moves the machine up and down. You can actually swap the handle over to the opposite side if you wish, which can make the machine easier to use in some applications. On the top of the machine there is the on-off button for the drill. And at the back there, we have the switch for the magnet. Once that is switched on, the magnet on it is incredibly powerful on this machine. It is virtually impossible to pull that off. It really is a very powerful magnet. So normally you'd leave that switched off until you get the drill in the exact correct position where you want to drill the hole, and then you would switch on the magnet at the back there, and that will hold it in position whilst you do the drilling. If you take a look at the cutters, you'll see that they have two flats machined on them. That is so that when the cutter's in there, there are two grub screws in that part, which actually hold the cutter in position. So all you need to do is take the hex key, undo the two grub screws, and then ensure the two flats are facing forwards. Insert that in the machine, and then tighten up the grub screws. So that's how to insert a bit into the machine. It is incredibly easy. There may come a time when you want to put a normal drill bit in there, so then it becomes a little bit more difficult. You have to swap that for the chuck. So I'll just undo the two grub screws. I'll just bring it forwards. And then this time we'll get the chuck again, ensuring that the two flats align with the two grub screws. Push that up. And again, tighten the two grub screws. So I'll just put a large drill bit in the chuck. This is a blacksmith's drill or a reduced shank drill. I've done this just to demonstrate how to use the machine properly. You will notice that if we lift the handles up fully, the drill bit will not go high enough. So what we need to do is get this lever undo that. It is actually a left-handed thread, and then you can actually get hold of the machine and you can pull that up high enough, and then you can lock that back in position. That means that you can use virtually any length of drill bit in this machine very easily. So once you've lifted it up high enough, you can then just use it as you would do if you're using a cutter, and you can quite simply drill your holes. So that is a very useful feature on this machine. I have used some mag drills in the past and struggled terribly putting the drill bit in, and we couldn't actually get the height to drill the holes that we needed to drill. So that is a very good idea on this machine. To fit the coolant bottle, it's very simple. Simply take the bracket, slide that over the cap head screw, just tighten that up where you want it. Take the bottle and the screw-in valve, screw that on there, and simply take that end and push that into the push fit connector there. You can then put coolant in the bottle there. It'll run down the hose into the machine, straight down, and it will come out in the centre of the cutter, ensuring that the cutter is kept cool. If you want to remove it, simply push in on the blue part and pull back on the hose. That is simply a quick release connector. The machine also comes with a guide that simply fits around the edges there, and you can then screw that into position using the wing bolts. So they simply screw into those holes. But for this demonstration, I'm not going to put the guide on, and then you can actually see the cutter doing the cutting. I'm now going to take this out on a job, and we're going to drill a steel beam for a home extension. So that's the Evolution Evo Mag 42. For the money, that is an absolutely fantastic piece of kit. I'd just like to thank Chris the Builder for lending me this machine, because this machine actually belongs to him.